All right, y'all, I'm super excited to make this video. Today, I'm gonna be going through an entire walkthrough of EzAlgo v3.5, some of my best practices, how to optimize the settings to your benefit, how to join the Discord if you're not in already, et cetera, and what to expect moving forward in the future. So I think this video is really gonna help out a ton of you guys. And I'm pretty much going to go through everything from A to Z, how to get started to making your first profitable trade with EzAlgo. And I'm so sick of all the bullshit in the trading community. I'm not going to overcomplicate anything. I'm not going to sugarcoat anything. I'm going to give it to you straightforward, how to use EzAlgo and start profiting on the first day. So first thing I'm going to talk about is how to join the Discord. So if you're not in the Discord already, hit the first link in the description below. You can join the Easy Trades Discord. And I'm going to go through it a little bit, just show you guys what to expect once you're in the Discord. So obviously we have the free section of the Discord, and we just added some free crypto signals in the free Discord. So if you're watching this right now, you can join the free Discord. You don't even have to have the algo yet. And you can copy the trades of some of our most successful traders. So I think that's super huge. Shout out to Eric and J Money for doing that. But we will be bringing a crypto tier starting September 1st. So stay tuned for that. If you want to copy some of our professional trader signals, you can do that. And we also have the VIP, obviously, where Rob will do live streams every day and give out real time option signals, right? No other Discord community is doing this, I promise. Okay. We have the top of the line traders, and I wouldn't just say that for no reason. We really do. So I'm super thankful to have all the traders in here that we have. And we're only just getting started. But if you just joined the Discord, what you're going to want to do is come over here to Unlock Premium and go to the EzAlgo website, www.ezalgo.co, and you'll be brought to this website right here. And you can kind of scroll down and see what's up with EzAlgo, kind of how it works, the inputs involved in it. Obviously, you know, we have some great results, and then you can come down here and press become a member. So let's just say you want the EzAlgo premium membership, which will give you access to the EzAlgo indicator as well as a pro Discord. You'll come over here and you'll be redirected to the checkout where you can press buy now. And as soon as you pay, you will have an option to connect with Discord. So it's super important that even if you've already been in the Discord, you want to reconnect through WAP.com. That will give you the pro access and then the channel to actually enter your Tradingview username. I know it's kind of confusing. Some people hit me up after they get EzAlgo and they say, how do I get the indicator? This is how you do it. You have to connect through Discord through the WAP.com platform, and then you'll go to the start here algo section of the Discord. Let me scroll down a little bit. Right over here, you'll go to start here, algo, and then you'll put your Tradingview username right there in this channel, and you will have access to EzAlgo, usually within around 8 hours. If I'm on, I'll add you immediately. I do have to sleep as well. I'm human, so if you're in a different time zone, I might be asleep, but as soon as I wake up, I'll add you to the indicator, and you can get started. If you don't have a Tradingview account already, you're going to come over here to tradingview.com, create an account. It doesn't take long. It'll take like 2 minutes. Just enter your email, get a username set up. I'm assuming most of you guys already have a Tradingview account, so you're just going to come over here to the chart. And at the left side here in the upper left, you can choose your asset. So EzAlgo works across any asset, right? So crypto, Forex, stocks, it actually works a little bit better on Forex and stocks, I've found out. But still, you know, it works wonders to trade on crypto. That's what I trade. And that's what most of our users trade. They'll trade crypto. So you can come over here to your chart. And first thing you're gonna wanna do is remove all drawings and indicators from your chart, okay? Because we're gonna start fresh, and I'm gonna walk you through A to Z how to get set up. So once you have access to the indicator, you're gonna come up here to indicators, right? You're gonna click that, and you'll see under your invite only scripts, you'll see EzAlgo v3.5, okay? Super important that it's the 3.5 one, and all of you guys will have that. Even if you had an older version, you'll just come right back here and it'll say EzAlgo 3.5. This is the most updated version of EzAlgo. When you load the indicator in, it will look something like this. And I'm on the Heiken Ashi candles. Just to start out, you can use either candles, right? It works on Japanese or Heiken Ashi. I prefer Heiken Ashi on a higher time frame, but if you're going to like the 5 minute and below, you really want to have the Japanese candles. And it kind of depends on what your trading strategy is, right? If you're trying to catch a swing failure pattern, you need the Japanese candles. But if you're just trading based off the zones and the strategies I'm going to show you, then you can use Heiken Ashi candles. It'll be a lot better, especially for beginners. But we're going to come in here to the settings of EzAlgo, okay? And you'll notice we have a ton of inputs, right? And it can be a little bit overwhelming, but I'm gonna go through each one. So first off, we have the buy and sell signals. And contrary to popular belief, you're not trading off of the buy and sell signals, okay? That is just a confirmation, usually once you're in the trade already, but you're not gonna base your trade off of the buy and sell signals. However, we do have some of the most accurate buy and sell signals. I think Trade IQ did a video of our algo. I think it was maybe 2 months ago, and it was one of the most accurate indicators that he's tested on his channel. He went through, back tested the entire indicator just based off of the buy and sell signals for, I think it was a year and a half, 2 years, something like that. And the results were far better than most other paid indicators. So, you know, if buy and sell signals are really your thing and you really want that in an indicator, then definitely EzAlgo is your go-to because our buy and sell signals are extremely accurate. We also have a trend ribbon, which shows the overall trend of the market. And if I zoom in over here, you'll be able to see it a little bit clearer, right? So as you can see behind these candles, we have this trend ribbon, right? You can see it go from red, and right around here, it flips to blue. You know, it's flipping again back to red. And there are strategies just around the trend ribbon. So you can trade solely with the trend ribbon, right? But you can see that as soon as the trend ribbon flips, price goes down, right? And this is real-time price action, so I'm not making any of this up. You can see right over here, the trend ribbon flips blue, price goes up a little bit, starts to flip back again, goes down, flips once more, and starts to go up. And then right here, it flips red again, and it starts to come down. So that's just another confirmation when you're in the trade, just to get a better idea of what the trend is and where the price could be going. All right, you can also obviously change the colors of the buy and sell signals and the colors of the trend ribbon. It's under ribbon fill color, so you can change all of these colors. Obviously, you can change the bar color as well. If I want to make this, let's say, yellow for a buy and let's say purple for a sell. I mean, that looks pretty ugly, but you could customize that a little bit yourself if that's something that you choose to do. And we do have an automatic stop loss and take profit too. So you can enter the percent in the stop loss, and that will be the percent for both the stop loss and the take profit. So if I put 1% in the stop loss, that means our stop loss is 1%, our first take profit is 1%, our second take profit is 2%, and our third is 3%. And you know, the higher the stop loss, the higher the take profit percentages will also be. But we can disable this by setting it to 0 just for now. And of course, we have the automatic support and resistance levels. Now, these are the bread and butter of this indicator, the support and resistance levels. This is the most underrated aspect of this indicator because you can solely trade based off of the support and resistance levels and be insanely profitable, right? So we have support and resistance 1, which is pretty much the support and resistance levels on whatever time frame you're using. So for example, I'm on the 30-minute time frame right now. SR1 would show support and resistance levels from the 30-minute time frame. And you can also, you know, change the line style, right? You can make it solid, dash, dotted, whatever. You can change the label text and make it bigger if you want, but we don't really need that right now. So we'll set this back to, what was that, normal? We'll set that back to normal. And then we have SR2, and SR2 allows you to add support and resistance levels from any time frame of your choosing onto the chart that you're choosing. So I can add support and resistance levels from the 1 hour time frame all the way down to the 15-minute time frame, right? Any time frame that you choose, you can add these levels from a higher time frame for more confluence, right? And you can see just how well price respects these support and resistance levels. So really powerful stuff. We also have the reversal signals, right? So the reversal signals are the small blue and red diamonds. The input in this is an overbought or oversold input. So when price is overbought, you will have a red diamond, right? And if you get that at a resistance level, it's even better. And when price is oversold, you'll get a blue diamond here at the bottom. So as you can see, if we just go back a little bit, right? And by the way, this is a non-repaint indicator. None of these inputs are repaint at all, okay? The support and resistance levels will, I don't want to say repaint, but we'll load in new levels in real time when price finds a support, but that's necessary. You need those autonomous support and resistance levels. If you don't have those, then they're useless. So you want real-time support and resistance levels, and that's what we have here with EzAlgo. And like I said, if I can go back, every time we get these blue diamonds, right, especially at a support level, price will react from that level, right? Blue diamonds, price goes up. We have a lot of red diamonds here, but once we're at the resistance level, it goes down. And you can just see this for yourself. Like I said, non-repaint, real-time indicators right here. We also have the previous day high, low, and close. So this is very important if you're trading an asset like Forex, right? You're gonna wanna have these levels on your chart. and it will show you the previous day high, low, and close, which is just another level of interest to take a potential trade at. We also have our EMAs, which is pretty self-explanatory. I'm sure most of you guys know what the EMAs are. Which again will help you find what the overall trend of the market is doing and help you kind of distinguish between those long and shorts, preferably on a higher time frame. And obviously these inputs are customizable in the style tab as well. And last but not least, we have the trend dashboard. Okay, I'm gonna get rid of some of this stuff. We have the trend dashboard. So this will show you kind of what the market is doing right now. So it'll give you the time frame and it will show you whether the market is bullish or bearish. All right, so super important. This can also help distinguish whether you're gonna take a long or short, right? If everything is bearish, you're not gonna be looking for a long, and vice versa. If everything is bullish, you're probably not gonna be looking for a short position. See, right now, everything is looking pretty bearish, so I'm really gonna be looking to fade any sort of pump that we get. So if we were to come back up to this resistance level, I'd be looking to take a short right there at any of these resistance levels. And I should also mention that the buy and sell signals have a sensitivity. So what the sensitivity does is pretty much dictate when the buy and sell signals appear. So if I go to, let's say, the 2 sensitivity, you know, the buy and sell signals will be a lot less, right? Which would be better for a higher time frame. But if I'm on, let's say, the 5-minute time frame, I'm probably gonna want more signals, right? So I could change the sensitivity, maybe 1.6 or so, somewhere around there. And obviously there will be more signals on a lower time frame. But like I said, you're not gonna be taking all of these signals. You're just gonna use them at the support and resistance levels. All right, and that is it for the EzAlgo inputs. All right, and now I'm gonna be getting into the best time frames for beginners, right? What is the best time frame and sensitivity to use for beginners? Well, in the Discord, we actually have a 24-page PDF that pretty much lays all of this out. But I'm gonna tell you guys again on this video my favorite time frame and what I recommend for beginners. So most optimal time frame would be 30 minutes to 1 hour, okay? And I know it's a higher time frame. Most of you want to scalp, but if you're looking for the most accurate trades and how to make the most possible gains, especially as a newbie or beginner trader, you're gonna want to zoom out a little bit and go to a higher time frame. Reason being is that price respects these support and resistance levels a lot more on these higher time frames, and the signals are also a lot clearer, right? I mean, these buy and sell signals just at support and resistance levels are super, super accurate, right? Obviously, you're not gonna be taking any of these signals down here because we haven't really come to a level. You would be taking this buy signal because we are at the support level and maybe taking that sell signal as well, right? So 30 minutes to 1 hour time frame, use a 1.5 sensitivity. Obviously, you can choose to unclick the buy and sell since you don't really need the buy and sell. And instead, you can have these little blue and red dots, right? A blue dot right here and a red dot right here to signify a momentum shift, which in essence, pretty much all the buy and sell signals are. So you can leave that unchecked if you want or keep that on. You're gonna leave the trend ribbon on, you're gonna have SR1 on, and set the SR2 to the 1 hour time frame. If you're on the 1 hour time frame, you don't need SR2, okay? You could use the 4 hour SR2, but I'd recommend, you know, keep the SR2 to the 1 hour time frame if you're on a time frame lower than the 1 hour. But if you're on the 1 hour time frame, you can just keep the SR1. Keep the reversal signals on because those are very helpful, especially, like I said, if you have a reversal signal at an EzAlgo support or resistance level, those are pretty reliable. And if you're more of a scalper and you want to go to a lower time frame, you can do the same thing, except keep the SR1 on, let's say, the 15-minute time frame, and keep the SR2 on the 1 hour as well. And you can even go down to the 5-minute, right, and do this with the 15-minute time frame. If you really want to scalp, you can turn SR2 to the 15-minute time frame and, you know, scalp that way as well. But obviously, that's a little bit more risky. And when you're doing this, you really want to wait until price comes to a high or low level, right? So I have these low levels identified as well as this high level up here. So these are the levels that you really want to be taking trades at. And now I'm going to be showing you how you can optimize EzAlgo to make the most possible gains when you're trading, right? And I'd recommend going on an altcoin, okay? Going to a low cap altcoin and trading some of these altcoins, guys, all right? Trade some of these altcoins, because when you trade some of these altcoins on a higher time frame, like the 30 minute to the 1 hour time frame, like I suggested, the gains are just unreal and the charts are super smooth. So I love to trade Bitcoin, Sol, Matic, and also some of these low cap coins like KNC USDT, which has been absolutely killing it, right? You're waiting for price to come to an easy algo level and then entering a trade when price comes to one of these levels. And to help you with this, another indicator I would highly recommend to use along with easy algo, and this, guys, this is the money printer, okay? This is what you guys have been waiting for. Using Vu Manchu Cipher B in confluence with EzAlgo. So what you're gonna do is wait for price to come to a level, right? For example, we have this clear resistance level up here, and you're looking for a green or red buy or sell dot on Vu Manchu Cipher B. I've customized my settings a little bit to match my algo, but the inputs are the same. And once you get that dot at a support or resistance level, you are going to enter a trade. Now, if you wanna be even more accurate, you can wait until you have a divergence, right? So as you can see here, we have a bullish divergence on Vu Manchu Cipher B, meaning there's a bigger wave and then a smaller trigger wave. And once that confirms, you are going to enter the trade. Like I said, make sure it's at an easy algo support level. And we had a buy signal on the exact same candle. So we're gonna enter that trade, put our stop loss below the previous swing low, and target the next resistance level, right? Target the next resistance level. Move your stop loss to break even after three or four candles, right? So you enter on this one, maybe one, two, three, four, maybe wait till it goes up a little bit more. Once you're in the trade and you're in some good profits, move your stop loss to break even, okay? And just to lock in that trade, and you'll be good to go. And this works on any time frame as well, right? If I go to the 1 hour time frame, you can see we had this bearish divergence right here, right? We had this bearish divergence. Momentum was making a new low as price was making a new high right into that same resistance level. So we're gonna enter that trade. We can enter before the divergence confirms, but just to be safe, we'll enter it after the divergence confirms, stop loss above previous swing high, and you know, targeting the next support level, maybe somewhere around here. Probably around here at the top of this wick right here. There's, you know, a big support zone right here. That's where we would be taking our profit. And you can do this both sides, right? Again, we have a bullish divergence confirms right here on the 1 hour time frame. We'll enter that trade, stop loss below previous swing low, target the next resistance level, and just keep doing that, right? Comes back up to this level. We get a red dot, another bearish divergence, and a sell signal. We'd enter that trade and target, you know, this level as well. All right, so that's the number one strategy I'd recommend for beginners. Like I said, you can go down to a lower time frame to snipe that entry, but I really do like the 1 hour time frame. But if you wanted to, you can go down to the 15 minute time frame and, you know, really snipe these entries, right? Look, we have a bullish divergence right at the support level and price goes up, right? And price goes up, you know, around 3%. You know, another bullish divergence right here at the support level. Once again, you know, price goes up. We have a red dot here with these reversal signals right at this easy algo resistance level. So even though we didn't get a divergence, you know, that's still a lot of confluence. And I would be very comfortable taking that trade, maybe stop loss right around there, you know, targeting this level for your first take profit and maybe this for your second take profit. And this came all the way down here. You know, a nice 7%, over 7% move. And we came right back down to this easy algo support level, right? As you can see, this has been a level that's acted as support in the past, and then resistance, and then support again. And now we're currently testing this as support once more. So definitely be sure to use Vu Manchu Cipher B as extra confluence when you enter these trades. And that is how you can use easy algo to be profitable on day one. Just to kind of cover everything again once more, what you're doing is waiting for price to come to a level. Use Vu Manchu Cipher B as confluence at these levels. Be on the lookout for these bullish and bearish divergences, and then use the buy and sell signals as confirmation after the fact once you enter the trade. And I'm gonna be dropping a lot of videos like this, as well as some of my strategy breakdowns on the Easy Algo channel as well. So be on the lookout for some of those videos. Like I said, if you want Easy Algo for yourself, hit the first link in the description below, and hope you guys have a great day.